Hey, what's going on, everyone? Today is November 22nd, 2020. This is probably the first review video that I have ever done for vinyl. And what compelled me to do this review video is just the sheer fact that such a legendary rock band of AC/DC pretty much made a comeback since we've last seen their last album drop, and this is actually their 17th studio album to drop international. And I just mysteriously came across one of their newest music videos, A Shot in the Dark, which dropped earlier this month, in November, I believe. And when I clicked on the video and I saw, you know, a few of the original members just jamming out like 100% all gas, I was just blown away that these people, you know, given their age, are still able to just pump out such electrifying music. And I got a digital copy that I purchased, and I listened through the entire album, and I have to tell you, Brian Johnson, the lead vocalist, and Agnes Young, you know, the lead guitarist, at their age, I think they're pushing 70 now or something around that neighborhood, they are going at full throttle. I'm talking about ain't no stopping them now. These guys are able to just perform, I think, even better on this album than they probably have done is in some of their younger albums. And it just blows my mind that, you know, as time and, you know, with age goes by, that these people are still just able to produce such good music that when you first listen to even the first track, you know you're listening to an authentic, legitimate rock and roll band. It just no denying that. So there are many variations of this vinyl album that have come out. There is this particular one which I've gotten. This is a Target exclusive. This particular one is a bundle which comes with the vinyl and a t-shirt. I know these sell like hotcakes right now because of the holiday season and everything else. These make perfect gifts. I mean, if you know someone who is a diehard AC/DC fan, or who just loves vinyl, or, you know, who are getting into vinyl, or who likes rock and roll, this is the perfect gift to get them to add to their collection. Get them while you can now, because they are selling out like hotcakes. I've seen them already drop on eBay, and they are already, you know, 15 to 20% higher than the retail value, and they are only expected to appreciate as time goes by. But this particular one, I'm going to open up. I'm going to do a review on it. I also have an exclusive limited Walmart edition, which is pressed on a red wax. So the entire record is red in tint. And that one, I think, is more highly sought after than this t-shirt bundle. And that one is already retailing for 25 to 35% above retail on eBay. And it's only expected to go higher too. And you can't even find that one at all at any of the Walmarts. I've been to a handful of them, and they just don't stock them in my area. Or they just sold out on it. Now, here's the back of this cover, you can see. And we'll go for the side shot here. Okay. You can see here it says Target Exclusive Bundle. It is pressed on a Columbia label. And that's pretty much it. So we'll go ahead and open this up, and we'll see what's inside. And then what I'll do for you is I'll go ahead and demo this. I'll throw it on my setup here. I'm going to be using, you know, the ultra reliable Stanton 881S, that is sporting the LP gear line contact stylus, which is actually made for Pickering XUV 3300 series. I did a lot of my research, and you know, that series of the Pickering are moving magnets. This is a moving magnet, not a moving iron, which a lot of people probably associate the Stantons with. The 681 models are a moving iron, but in any case, listening to hi-fi audio is the best experience you can get next to being live in a concert. If you love music, get yourself a decent audio setup, decent vinyl, and you will enjoy the listening experience, and it can last you a lifetime if you take care of it. And you know, just simply you know, don't abuse it at all. So let's open this up. Let's see what's inside. I want to kind of keep this clean, because you know, if I don't really like it, I'm going to bring it back actually, but I highly doubt that this is going to be staying with me. So let's see what's inside of here. There we go. Just want to keep this as clean as I can. Okay, so we got this opened up here. And we'll slide out what we have. Let's see. Ooh, in fact, everything is just wanting to come out at this point. Let's see. Let's do with the top layer first. Let's start with that. Okay, so first and foremost, here's the album. Here we are, and I'll let you just kind of read up on some of this here. There we are. Okay, the skew, everything else. So we'll set this aside for now. And then we'll go ahead and see what else we got inside of here, which is, I believe, this shirt. Okay, yeah, that's the shirt. Here's the shirt. And I'm not going to attempt to open this. I'm pretty sure you've seen another review video or pictures online. You can see it on Target's website, how the shirt looks like. We'll set that aside for now. Then we'll go ahead and open the vinyl here, and then we'll see how this one is. Okay, there we are. There is some kind of a design on the inside, which I have seen in other videos. Unfortunately, you won't be able to see that here. There's also some artwork. Again, you won't be able to see that here. But what I'm interested in is the vinyl and the sound quality of it. Now, I've already seen some dynamic range posted online for the CD album, and it's actually quite, you know, miserable if you think about it. At this day of age, given the technology that we have, it's only scoring about a 9 on the dynamic range average. And I think there is one vinyl posting, and on most of the tracks, I believe, they were getting 11. So 11 is the target that I'm looking for with the vinyl album. And with that being said, I'm curious to see what I can get out of my setup. And I don't really see anyone else really posting a video on the sound quality on this new album yet. Not too sure why. Maybe if it's because of YouTube's horrendous copyright policy, which I do respect in some extent. A lot of the artists are not getting their fair due, even with today's streaming platforms. The compensation is just not as rewarding as the days of when you had to walk into a record store or, you know, a music shop and purchase, you know, a CD album or a cassette tape album or a vinyl album. Those days are gone too. So this is the inner sleeve, and it looks phenomenal. I mean, you can look at this and look at the artwork. I'm going to sharpen this up a little bit. It just looks absolutely phenomenal there. You can see all of the members here. I mean, and yeah, Brian Johnson there is just awesome. Here is the other side. Alright. Let's take a look at that for a second and digest that. We can digest all of this here. Okay, so we got that out the way. Then, next, let's look at the actual disc itself. And as you can see, even with a brand new vinyl, a lot of you newbies out there think that, you know, because it's a new vinyl, that it's just going to play crystal clear and it's going to be excellent right out the box, and that's just not the case. You can clearly see there are debris already embedded in the vinyl. Okay, and that's just from the factory. You can see that here. You can see. So with that said, we're going to have to clean this with my microcarbon brush that I use on all of my vinyl to prepare it for play. So we'll do that now, and then I'm going to demo one track without any filters like I try to use on most of my vinyl unless they're heavily worn. I'll try to post one track so you can hear the sound of it. Hopefully YouTube will not flag me for that. And then we'll do a dynamic range readout on that. And you can go online and we can do the research to see what it compares with. And if we get an accurate reading that corresponds to someone else's reading, then we know that that's the true sound of this vinyl. And also, we can see how it fares out with the digital version, which I know will blow that away. So with that, I'll go ahead and pause the video and then we'll get the camera oriented to its usual position.
He loves to drive him crazy with his evil lips. Great guns ablazing. My deadly trip. Gonna send you down.